to give him a draw, but he actually beat him. Next time, you got to remember one thing. Tyson Fury hadn't fought anybody in about 2 or 3 years. You know, he didn't have no tune-ups and this type of thing. So he went in there really rusty. But now the man is sharp as a razor. A whole different ball game. His confidence is up and high.
Did you watch the Pacquiao-Thurman fight?
Yeah.
What was your take? What did you take away from that fight?
Well, I got to give Pacquiao credit. I picked him. I picked him to win the fight.
Even though you're from Florida?
Even though he's from Florida. I don't think too much.
No, Thurman's from Florida.
I don't think too much of Thurman. I think Thurman's a front runner. I think he's a front runner. Can't take it to the body. I seen him in a couple of fights get up out of there. So I picked Pacquiao, but it was a good night of watching cartoons for me.
Why?
That's what it was.
Cartoons, it was a great fight, man.
I thought it was entertaining.
I was always a Pacquiao fan, but I picked Thurman because of the young guy. But Pacquiao put on a hell of a performance. He got the W.
What is next for Manny? Do you want to see a Floyd rematch? Do you want to see Spence, Porter winner, the Mikey Garcia, Danny Garcia?
Well, if I was Pacquiao, I wouldn't be messing with Errol Spence. Better leave Errol Spence alone.
True, yeah, I believe
too big, too strong?
Too big, too strong,
but
too good.
Pacquiao signed up to fight all guys. So me, just like when Trinidad fought all the top Olympians, I'm looking forward to see what's going to happen.
I mean, it's very interesting, but he's going to be in trouble with Errol Spence.
I agree with
that's
you.
All
is Spence the pound for pound king for you? Is he the number one fighter in the world right now?
No, until I see him in Terrence fight.
I have to say, that's hard to say, but I think Spence would beat Terrence. I don't think Terrence strong enough.
I'm looking for a great fight. That
Terrence is a good fighter. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. He's a good fighter. He could become a great fighter. But right now, I don't think he's strong enough to beat Errol Spence. Errol Spence is all around good fighter, inside, outside, can box. And he showed you against Mikey Garcia how well he can box. Even Sugar Ray Leonard and all of us saying that Michael was too smart and all this, but Errol Spence showed him that, look, I'm just as smart as Michael, or smarter, and I'm bigger.
Manny Pacquiao, how many more years, how many more fights do you think? Because he looks amazing. He looks like a 30-year-old, even though he's 40.
Listen, anybody can look young against a coward. I keep trying to tell you that man's a front runner.
You think Thurman's a coward? He's a champion. He was 29-0.
He got his ass beat by a 40-something-year-old fighter.
But Manny's special. Okay. Division champion.
Ain't nobody that special. Nobody that special. Old man beat him. Old man beat him. How you gonna let old man beat you?
You supposed
to be pound for pound the best. Legend, hell, pound for pound the best. You let a 40-year-old man beat you. 40-year-old man's gonna get on.
I said this thing. Thurman's career gonna be going crazy now because Pacquiao beat him.
But it was a good fight.
No, you're right. It was a good fight.
And I will say this. One thing, Stacey, I was impressed. Thurman, the way he carried himself, his first pro loss, he kept a nice composure.
What did I just tell you? You're going to keep you glad to be out of there. Yeah, he was glad to be out of there. Okay? Yeah, I've been doing this stuff for 45 years.
Adrian Broner or Keith Thurman, who wins?
Keith Thurman? I got to go with Keith Thurman against Adrian. Yeah, because Adrian won't turn his he won't let his hands go.
If he lets his
hands go. He may beat him, but I have to go with him. So
I think Adrian got one more big fight of him if he concentrates on it. Cuz he ain't never really got really beat up.
No.
Okay. You work with Mike Tyson.
Right.
I've been comparing Gervonta Davis to Mike Tyson. There's a lot of similarities. Obviously Mike Tyson was a heavyweight. Gervonta Davis 130. But the energy that he has, the power, the charisma, do you see any similarities at all?
Yeah.
Like what?
I've said the same thing. I love his, that boy can fight. He's speechless. It's unbelievable how good this kid really is. This kid is so talented. And he punch with either hand, he just almost in a class by himself. I mean, I'm a fan of his. I like watching him fight. He's dangerous. He's just like Tyson, Joe Lewis, some kind of guy. He's strong, punch,
Mike Tyson,
short shots.
You worked with him for many years, many fights. Is it true he could hit hard with both hands?
Yeah.
Where do you hit harder, left or right?
Either hand.
Same thing?
I think the left hook might have been a little bit stronger, but he could knock you out with one punch. Either hand, he could break a bone. He could break bones.
What was his secret of success? His head movement, his footwork, his natural God-given power?
He was all-around good fighter. Customato did a fantastic job with him. When I first got with him, I was kind of puzzled. I was trying to figure out his fight style because he didn't fight like Joe Frazier. Everybody tried to say, even Emmanuel Stewart said, well, you know, he got that Joe Frazier weaving in Bob. He didn't weave in Bob. A lot of guys like Joe, they weave in Bob. But Mike rolled. He didn't weave in Bob.
He
rolled shot like that. He had a U.
And
And it was a fantastic job that Customada taught him. He taught him the right hand stance of boxing. But by him being a short guy, he turned him around. Once I figured that out, he turned him around. I said, damn, this guy is so talented, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, great uppercuts too. We don't see a lot of inside fighting today.
Yes, you do.
With Gervonta, but now...
Well, Gervonta, you didn't really see Gervonta fighting inside. He just... Y'all haven't seen all the stuff that this kid
can do. Now, what he just said, I saw Mike one day, he was in Phoenix in training camp, mm-hmm. and he made a move in the ring, right? And I said, Mike, I never seen you do this before. That's after being with him 2 years. He said, a lot of things I can do you never seen me do because there's nobody to make him do it. So basically, that's what he's saying.
You have to dig in a bag of tricks.
That's what he's saying.
Okay. What was your favorite moment with Mike Tyson away from boxing, just in life, in his house, chilling, or in a hotel, or on the road? Any moment stand out to you? Like
the favorite moment?
Mm-hmm.
Outside of boxing?
Yeah, away from the ring. Nothing to do with boxing, just in life. Like, do you ever go with them, like, hanging out, party, pool party, casino?
I don't hang out. I don't part with the fighters. But I would say his 28th birthday party.
What was that like?
In Connecticut. There? Everybody was there. You know, all the fighters was there. All the entertainment. Tupac wasn't allowed to come because they had told Mike that something might happen to him, so he wasn't out. Donald Trump, everybody was there.
Donald Trump was there?
Yeah, you know, Donald Trump and President.
Now he's the president.
Donald Trump and Tyson's real tight. Donald Trump and Don King is tight. You know, real tight. So, you know, me and Donald Trump go way back when he's promoting shows on
that. What did you bring Mike Tyson for his 28th birthday, Stacey? What gift did you bring?
What did I bring, Mike? I came to him and said, look, I'm going to bring you the championship. I'm going to help you win the title. So he won the WBC to heavyweight championship. Right after that, that was enough.
People don't know Tyson. They think his image of, like, he's a monster. He's actually a very soft-spoken guy. He's a good dude. People don't know that. They see the image of, like, the beast fighter.
Well, he's a good dude, you know, but he had different personalities. So you had to know his personality. You had to know when to stop. You know, Mike had a thing where if he didn't want to be bothered, he would do this. When you do that, you get the hell to leave him alone.
Give him space.
But most people want to press him with that issue. They want to press him.
Yo, he giving me some service.
You got to talk to Tank, yeah.
Yeah. But boy.
Give him space because he's public property. He's not an individual anymore. So
if you don't, I remember once, Showtime, he was doing an interview in Phoenix, Arizona. And so they came in, he didn't want to do an interview. He said, I don't want an interview. They kept pressing. So he jumped up, I was going to wrap his hands. Took the cameras, threw them against the wall, ran everybody out. So I ain't going to call the lady name that was working with Showtime at the time, she said. So I told Mike, I said, Mike, you just missed one camera over there. I said, he took that one and threw it against, he said, Stacy, why would you tell him to throw the camera against the wall? Why did you say, do you want to go against the wall or do you want Mike to get that damn camera against the wall? Okay? I can get it. I said, listen, you can buy some old cameras, but you don't want your ass spattered over the wall, okay?
Okay.
So then when we sit down and I was wrapping his hand, right? You got to use, a lot of times you got to use different psychology on these guys, especially with a killer. You got a killer fighter. Mike was a killer fighter. So I was wrapping his hand. He said, you know, I get tired of doing these interviews. Why don't you just leave me the fuck alone? So I'm wrapping his hand. I said, look, I said, listen, Mike, let me tell you something. Do you know what your job is? He said, what's my job? I said, your job is to drive pretty cars, keep a pocket full of spending money, knock out motherfuckers. I said, that's all you're supposed to do. And he loved it. I said, because that's what he loved doing anyway. I said, you drive pretty cars, you fornicate with pretty women, you knock out motherfuckers, you keep a pocket full of spending money. That's all you're supposed to do. And when you finish fighting, then you can do all this other stuff. I said, check out what Jack Johnson said. Same thing, basically. He loved that. So you got to be able to talk to these guys, man.
So let me ask you this. When you were around him, did he have his tiger yet or not yet?
Yeah, he has a tiger named Kenya. I remember when he was a kitten. And I remember when he grew up to be damn near 600 pounds. And Mike, you say, Stacy, that you afraid of that cat? That cat know you afraid of him. But he said, hell yeah, I'm afraid
he's
of him.
He's gonna eat you.
Yeah, so he was feeding him quarter chicken legs. You go in the cage and feed him a chicken leg. I said, no, I ain't doing that shit. But Mike would do it, you know, you get him cracking his bones.
Did the tiger love him?
Oh yeah, I love him. Then one day he knocked Mike out.
How did he knock him out?
He stopped him, it was in the pool.
Uh-huh.
Bow!
Slapped him?
Hell yeah, slapped the shit out of him. And his head hit up against the dog side of the pool.
He could have drowned. What, were you there? Somebody saved him?
Somebody told us.
Yeah.
There's a lot of stories. You know, it's you got different fighters got different personalities.
Correct.
I've always had crazy fighters.
Do you like that? It makes it more fun, more interesting.
Crazy fighters.
Never a slow day at the office, coach, when your fighters
never
fight.
It keeps you on your toes.
No, they'll fight.
But you have to.
They
be,
will fight.
But you have to be a coach, a father, a brother, a psychologist, psychiatrist, support system. Know if to be a bail bonds guy.
You got to do all of it.
A parole officer. All in one.
You got to do all of it. If you're not willing to do that, you know you're in the wrong business. Especially, you know, I remember when Leon Spinks was getting ready to fight Larry Holmes, and I was in training camp with Dale Williams and all of them. And if the fighter can fight, then you got to deal with all that stuff. If you can't fight, then you don't deal with all that stuff.
So if Mike is watching, what do you tell him right now?
Mike, living a good life. Thanks for everything, brother. And keep up the good work.
And Stacy, where do people follow you on social media? Twitter, Instagram, Facebook?
I ain't into all of that.
Nothing.
I don't need all that headache. I got enough headaches.
All right. There you have it. Look out for him. Doing big things in boxing for how many years now?
45.
45 years. FaceTheRoot.com and Seckbach reporting. Thanks so much.